Second, Robert Hagney's theory of hierarchical learning. Robert Mills Gagne was an American educational psychologist, best known for his conditions of learning. Gagne pioneered the science of instruction. During World War II, when he worked with the Army Air Corps training pilots, he went on to develop a series of studies and works that simplified and explained what he and others believed to be good instruction. Hagney was also involved in applying concepts of instructional theory to the design of computer-based learning and multimedia-based learning. He was categorized 8 level of hierarchical learning. Different capacity for performance. Type 1 single learning, type 2 stimulus response connection, type 3 motor chaining, type 4 verbal association, type 5 multiple discrimination, type 6 concepts, type 7 results, type 8 problem solving. Detail about first single learning. Learn to make general response to stimuli according to Pavlov. Second, SR learning. Learn to respond to a discriminated stimulus. Detail going on. First, single learning. In the same as the classical conditioning of behavioral psychologist Pavlov, classical conditioning is a learning process that occurs through associations between an environmental stimulus and a naturally occurring stimulus. Second, stimulus response learning, also known as trial and error, is a fundamental method of solving problems. It is characterized by repeated, varied attempts, which are continued until successes or until the agent stops trying. Here there is strong bond between S or theory taking place. 3. Chaining. Chaining is a procedure used in behavioral psychology. It involves reinforcing individual responses occurring in a sequence to form a complex behavior. It is a process of connecting a set of individual stimulus response in sequential order. There are two different types of chains, homogeneous and heterogeneous. The pair homogeneous chains occur when the form of response is similar in each element. By contrast, a heterogeneous chain requires different types of responses for each link. 4. Verbal association learning is connected to chain learning by using words. Here, the learner is able to verbalize the acquired knowledge and intellectual skills in a highly organized manner. Learning hierarchy, in another interpretation, it is a form of associated learning called paired association, such as learning the meanings of a word by splitting the word. Five, discrimination learning is the ability to distinguish or discriminate one chain from another, and this the learner can distinguish one stimulus from another and respond as per change in stimulus. The process is made more difficult by the act of interference. 6. Concept learning is a learning of generalized idea, and this the subject acquires the ability to understand the common but variable properties of a concept. Concept stands for generalized idea of a group of stimuli. 7. Concept learning, the change in behavior as a result of learning is not collected by a particular stimulus but by the abstract idea of each stimulus. Seven, rule learning. Chaining of two or more concepts is involved in learning a rule. This requires higher level cognition process. It involves building relationship among two or more concepts before learning higher order rule, that is enveloping them. 8. Problem solving. Problem solving is the highest level cognitive process. It is formulating of new and complex rules and procedure for the purpose of solving the problem. Problem solving leads to permanent change in the learner's capabilities, where in the learner has learned something more than learning of parts. Thank you. Have a wonderful day.